In this movie, a single sample diversity analysis will be calculated starting from pre-processed sequence read sets. The 16S identification analysis in BioNumerics relies on two reference files. First, the alignment algorithm implemented in the metagenomics analysis requires the presence of a reference alignment, which is used to align the sample sequences to. Second, the methods implemented to obtain classification results on the read sequences rely on the presence of a reference taxonomy to assign the read sequences to. First, we can check the presence of the uploaded reference alignment. There too, I select Database, Sequence Databases, Reference Alignments. When selecting one of the loaded reference alignments, detailed information including the alignment length and the number of sequences is displayed at the right. Similarly, we will check the loaded reference taxonomy. Selecting a taxonomic database from the list updates the detailed information including the number of taxonomic levels that are defined and the number of sequences included. For more information on these reference files, check out our video on the reference alignment and reference taxonomy for metagenomics analysis. A metagenomics project can be initiated from three different windows: the main window, the sequence reset window, as well as the metagenomics window. In this movie, we will start a new metagenomics analysis from the sequence reset experiment window. First, we open a trimmed dataset in the sequence reset experiment card. From this window, a summary of the characteristics of the sequence reset is displayed. We can initiate the analysis by selecting the analysis menu and choosing Single Sample Diversity Analysis. This will open a dialog where one can choose which way the operational taxonomic units are defined. For this analysis, I will leave the first option checked, which determines the OTUs by sequence clustering. By choosing this option, the unique sequences in the sequence read set are defined and distances are calculated between the reads. Based on the calculated distance matrix, a cluster analysis is then created and OTUs are defined based on a sequence identity threshold. The option Determined by Taxonomic Identification will identify the sequences against the reference taxonomy and create OTUs from the obtained taxonomic identification results. And the last option is a combination of the two methods previously mentioned. First, we enter the parameters for the sequence clustering procedure. Leave the sequence identity threshold unaltered and make sure the correct reference alignment is selected. Second, you can select calculators to be used by the diversity analysis. For the current example, we will use the default calculators. To see which calculators are included in these settings, select Custom Calculators. From the dialog that is displayed, the coefficients for the diversity calculations and for the calculations of rarefaction and collector curves can be queried. After confirmation, a dialog pops up asking if you would like to run the metagenomics analysis in a dedicated window. Clicking Yes starts the calculation in the metagenomics window. The calculations are organized in different project tasks, illustrated as blocks in the project pipeline. The progress of the calculations can be followed on the progress bar. Once the calculation has finished, an overview of the generated results, which are a range of different visualizations datasets, and text tables is present in the Data Source Overview panel. With these data sources, reports can be generated. For the analysis, predefined report templates are available. To create a report from one of the templates, click the Add Report from Template button. Depending on the available data sources, different templates become available and are listed in the Create Report dialog. As a start, simply select the input report. The input report displays charts on sequence length, sequence quality, the number of ambiguous bases in the reads, and the maximum homopolymer length. Additionally, we can open the rarefaction report for observed richness. I choose the unique reads and reads at 97 and 92% similarity. In this report, a small explanation about the rarefaction curves is displayed, and the chart displaying the rarefaction curve for the unique reads and the 97 and 92 similarity bins. Note that for the 92% similarity, the curve is leveling off, indicating the number of observed OTUs is leveling off to this specific value, whereas for the results for the unique reads, no plateau is reached. Similar observations can be made from the collector report. This report describes the richness or diversity change as sample size increases. Another predefined report that can be called is the OTU report. In this report, an overview is given of the different groups that are considered for each of the similarity levels. The rank abundance overview indicating the number of OTUs for each level, and the species abundance overview indicating the dominant OTU size for each level are displayed next to the individual rank and species abundance curves for the specified similarity levels. Note that analysis on sequence read sets can be initiated on multiple entries simultaneously. Thereto, select all the entries that you want to use in the analysis and select from the analysis menu Sequence read sets types, single sample diversity analysis. This will start the calculations without opening the metagenomics window and launches one metagenomics analysis after the other.